friends, I am Shantanu, your coach, and now we are going to see how the value of car provided to employee by the employer will be taxable in the hands of employee as a motor car perquisite. So first, let's go to the case first. Suppose there is employer who has owned one car. So owner of the car is employer. And the actual cost of this car to employer is 6 lakh rupees only. Apart from this, the employer is incurring an annual expenditure of 80,000 rupees on this car. Now let's see, suppose this car is given to an employee wholly for official purpose. Remember, this employee is using this car wholly for official purpose, then nothing will be taxable in the hands of employee, provided the employer is maintaining the details of journey performed by the employee in this car, plus he also certify this details of journey performed. So nothing will be taxable if the employee is using wholly for official purpose. Now let's see, suppose this car is given to an employee who is using it wholly for personal purposes. Now in that case, the taxable value of perquisite in the hands of employee will be the expenditure incurred by the employer plus 10% per annum of the actual cost. Remember, in this case you have to see the expenditure incurred by the employer, that is 80,000 rupees, plus also you have to see the actual cost of this car, that is 6 lakhs. So 10% of 6 lakhs you have to take. So if we do the calculation, in this case, the calculation will be taxable amount of perquisite will be 1,40,000 rupees. How it is coming? 80,000 rupees is the expenditure incurred by the employer, and 60,000 rupees is just the 10% of the actual cost to the employer. Now let's take another case. Suppose this car has been given to an employee for both the purposes, personal purpose as well as official purpose. So he is using it for personal as well as official purpose. Now in this case, very typical, you have to take assumed figures. Remember, you have to take assumed figure in this case. Let's see what will be the taxable amount in this case. So taxable amount will be 1800 rupees per month or 2400 rupees per month plus 900 rupees per month if the driver is also provided along with the car. It doesn't matter how much salary a driver is getting. You need not to. You have to check all the assumed figure in this case. You just have to check whether the car is small or big and whether the driver is also provided or not. So if the car is small, you have to take 1800 per month. Now I should clarify here. When I say small car, it means the capacity of the car is 1600cc. Up to 1600cc, then you have to take 1800 per month. And if the car is big, it means if the capacity of car is more than 1600cc, then you have to take 2400 per month. And for driver, additional driver provided, you have to take 900 rupees per month. So you carefully note here, for personal and official, both the purposes he is using, then you just forget about the actual expenditure and the actual cost. You just have to deal with the assumed figure. Now assuming that this car is a small car, you have to take 1800. Now let's see what will be the taxable amount in this case. So taxable amount of perquisite in this case will be 1800 rupees per month into 12, because the car is small. Small means up to 1600cc. And if the driver is also provided to employee, you have to take 900 rupees per month. So 900 into 12. So total taxable perquisite is coming 32,400. Again, I am repeating, if the case is falling under personal plus official purpose, then you need not to consider the actual expenditure and the actual cost. You just have to deal with the assumed figure. Now let's see another case. This is also a case when personal and official, both the purposes employee is using, but remember additional information is given. The employer is incurring expenditure only for official purposes here. So personal purpose ke liye employee is incurring the expenditure himself. So he is not getting any reimbursement for personal use. So in this case, there will be a lesser amount of taxable perquisite because personal expenses he is not charging or he is not getting from the employer. So here the taxable value of perquisite will be 600 per month or 900 per month depending upon the small or bigger car, plus 900 per month if the driver is also provided. So in this case, if we calculate the taxable value, suppose the car is a small car, he is using for both the purpose, but employer is doing the expenditure only for official purpose. Personal expenditure is whatever is incurred by the employee, he is bearing the cost. Now in this case, 600 per month into 12 because the car is small, and if the driver is also provided, 900 rupees per month into 12. So total coming 18,000 rupees will be the value of taxable perquisite. Now please carefully note here, official purpose, nothing is taxable, just the employer will have to maintain a record. If it is for personal, wholly for personal purpose, remember you have to check the actual expenditure, add the actual cost of the car, and then you have to do the calculation. Now you can ask, sir, personal purpose ke liye diye aur driver bhi diya tha saath mein, to uska kya? To wo actual expenditure jo hai 80,000, usme driver ki salary bhi include kar li jayegi, maan li jayegi, whatever usme hi include karna hai employer ki cost. So 80,000 expenditure by the employer plus 10% of the actual cost in case of a personal. Now when you go to personal and official purpose, means he is using for both the purpose, remember actual expenditure incurred by the employer and the actual cost you just have to totally ignore. You have to deal in the assumed figure. So taxable value of the perquisite, you have to take 1800 or 2400 per month, and if the personal expenditure is not borne by the employer, then you have to take 600 per month or 1900 per month. And for driver also, you have to add 900 per month. Now let's move to another case. In this case, we assume that car is owned by the employee. So owner is employee himself. So here the actual cost of the car doesn't matter because it is owned by the employee himself. What is important? The expenditure is incurred by the employer. So although the car is owned by the employee, but the expenditure is incurred by the employer. Let's say the expenditure incurred by the employer is 80,000. Now how to calculate the taxable value of perquisite in this case? So first you see the taxable expenditure will be very very simple. The actual expenditure incurred by the employer minus, see, first time you are seeing the minus sign. So minus expenditure incurred for official purpose. So 80,000 jo bhi expenditure kiya hai, isme se official purpose ke liye kitna kiya hai, wo deduct kar dijiye, and rest will be the taxable amount of perquisite. Now you will ask, sir, how to find out the expenditure for official purpose? Now the guidelines are that ki if employer has maintained the record for whatever is spent for official purpose, then you just simply have to deduct that. For example, if employer has maintained the record that 30,000 rupees was spent for official purpose, so total expenditure was 80,000 minus 30,000 for official expenditure, so remaining 50,000 will be taxable in the hands of employee. Now you will say, sir, if he has not maintained the record, how much is spent on official purpose? What to do now? So here also a guideline is there that in that case you have to deal with the assumed figure. We will assume here, remember, we will assume that the expenditure for official purpose is 1800 per month or 2400 per month. depending upon the car is small or bigger. And also, if the driver is also provided, you have to take 900 per month as the official purpose use of the driver. Now, if in this case we take example, suppose the car is a small car, 80,000 was the total expenditure. Now, expenditure for official purpose, we are assuming the car is small, so 1800 into 12. And driver was also provided, so 900 into 12. Both these figures will be deducted. So 80,000 minus this, you will get 47,600 will be the value of taxable perquisite in the hands of the employee. Now let's see a unique case, unique luxurious case, that employer has given more than one car to employee. What will be the taxable amount? So remember, one car out of so many car, one car will be treated as personal and official purpose depending upon the choice of the employee. Now employee can choose which car he want to treat as personal purpose, official purpose, and the taxable value, as we have seen, 1800 or 2400 per month plus 900 if the driver is also provided per month. And what about the remaining car? Remaining cars will be treated as solely for personal use. So you have to calculate the each car, each additional car, you have to calculate the actual expenditure incurred by the employer plus 10% per annum of the actual cost of each car. You have to calculate like that, and the total will be the value of perquisite in the hands of employee. Now, if you want to watch more videos, you can register yourself at www.cscscmacoach.com.